Hello, my name is Laetitia Lachenam. I'm a PhD student in Rennes, France, within INRIA's CIDRE team. Today, I'm going to talk about Set2Graph, an ad hoc attack detection tool based on novelty detection on structured data graphs. First, I would like to define our motivation and the problem we try to solve. Security Operational Center, or SOC, is a generic term describing a platform that provides detection and reaction services against security incidents. There are 5 steps in the SOC procedure when facing an attack. These steps are source, sense, detect, monitor, respond and recover. The first step consists in collecting information from all available sources, being internal or external. This can be logs, records of session flows, threat intelligence, or alerts coming from intrusion detection systems. The second step consists in sorting, normalizing the data, or pre-processing it. It also includes linking threat intelligence and internal data when an indicator of compromission is detected, for example. The first step is to detect the attack. There exist 2 methods, misuse-based and anomaly-based. The first step is to present the results to the analyst with a dashboard, for example. Finally, the fifth step is to put in place procedures to eliminate the threat and get back to a normal system. We choose to focus on the 3 first steps and to use an anomaly-based detection method. We identified 5 challenges to address. First, the information system is heterogeneous, which makes it hard to supervise. Second, there are diverse types of information sources. Third, it is difficult to interpret the results of intrusion detection systems based on anomaly detection. All of this can be summarized in 1 question. How can we construct a good behavior model? And my answer is with a graph model. Another problem is, should I use a supervised or an unsupervised algorithm? Labeling data is very time consuming, so we prefer an unsupervised method. Finally, analysts waste a lot of time analyzing false alarms. I hope I'll be able to show you in this presentation that our approach based on the graph model helps against this problem. To summarize our contribution, in our approach named Set2Graph, we propose to encode heterogeneous network events in a graph to better detect anomalies using an unsupervised approach. In the following, I will describe each step of Set2Graph's workflow. Then I will show you our experimental setups and presenting results. I will conclude with a summary of our contributions and propose future work. Set2Graph is made of 3 modules: the graph builder, the graph encoder, and the novelty detector. We take as inputs network captures and retrieve metadata from network connections generated by an intrusion detection system. These pieces of metadata are log files that we transform into a graph thanks to our first module, the graph builder. This graph cannot be directly used by a machine learning algorithm that requires vectors as input. Our graph encoder module, therefore, encodes the information in the graph as vectors, which are then entered into the novelty detector. This novelty detector allows us to detect anomalies in our graph and hopefully attacks. We detail each module in the following. The first module, the graph builder, takes network events and generates a graph representation. It parses the data and extracts relevant pieces of information that we call security objects. These security objects become the nodes of our graphs, and we link nodes that belong to the same event with timestamped edges. We build our data model by taking inspiration from the threat intelligence model STIX. This model is based on the extraction of sub-elements called cyber observable, which can be easily linked to indicators of compromission, such as the IP address of a malicious actor. We extended the model to extract the elements that we believe allow us to link events together. In the paper, our model is built on zclock files, but it can be extended to any sources of information on the same basis. Our model is centered on a principal class called network connection. This class is built from the con.log files. The fields of this type of event are written at the top. From these fields, we extract the UID representing the identifier of one connection, the source IP address, ID or H, the destination IP address, ID resp H, and the destination port, ID resp. These elements can directly link two events or be linked with external pieces of information. On the contrary, the source port is often set dynamically and is not often representative of any link between two elements. Therefore, we keep this piece of information in the network connection class. We repeat the process with another type of log file, namely ftp.log, that groups specific information about FTP connections. In this type of log, we extract UID and FUID, respectively the network connection identifier and the identifier of a file transfer. We build two new objects that we attach on the ones already built. Similarly, with the file.log file that groups every piece of information about file transfer, we extract FUID and conUIDs and create one new class and one new type of edge. This process was repeated for all types of events until we got our full model. This principle is based on the work of the analyst, who often proceeds in stages, looking for useful information and then using it as research elements to be found in other events. By creating these links upstream, this analysis is facilitated because the link already exists. Here is the resulting graph model with various objects corresponding to the various types of protocols that the IDSZ can decode. This graph can easily be extended with new types of data only by adding new objects. To illustrate the process of building a graph representing network events from the model, I take three heterogeneous events generated with Zeek. The three events are a connection log extracted from the con.log file, an FTP connection extracted from the FTP.log file, and a file transfer log extracted from the files.log file. At the bottom left, I have generated three subgraphs that correspond to our three events based on our model. We see that there are two objects file transfer with the same FUID, and two object network connections with the same UID. Thus, at the bottom left of the slide, I have merged these objects. The merging operation has naturally connected the three events. I repeated these steps with all the events and got a representation of many events in one big graph. The graph we obtain is heterogeneous, that is to say it has different types of nodes and different types of edges, and all of its nodes have attributes. To perform any machine learning algorithm on it, you must first encode the graph in vectors. Classical graph representation represents nodes in vectors, but we choose to represent edges. The anomaly is based on the edge in the node. We want to extract these anomalies. For example, a connection on a particular IP address can be abnormal, while an IP address by itself is not. We want to preserve the structure of the graph, that is to say the notion of relations between the nodes and their neighbors, but we also want to preserve the content, that is to say the different attributes of the node. To do this, we take into account five types of information. First, the edge type. For example, a source address is an edge type. This type is encoded in a binary vector using the method of one-hot encoding. This well-known method of feature engineering converts categories attributes in binary vectors. Details can be seen in the paper. Second, we build a feature vector representing the attributes of the source node. The node is blue. And then we will use well-known feature engineering methods described in the paper. Third, we do the same for the destination node, the node red. Fourth, we represent the neighborhood of the source node, circled in blue, by aggregating information of all neighbors nodes in one vector. And finally, fifth, we do the same for the neighborhood of the destination node, circled in red. We concatenate all the five vectors in one unique vector and get the encoding of an edge. In this vector, we have encoded both the content and the structure of the graph. The third module is the novelty detector. This module takes the vector previously built and predicts if the corresponding edge is normal or abnormal. If the graph representation of this event contains this edge, the event is also considered as abnormal. Let's get more in details of the method. The novelty detector is mainly an autoencoder. An autoencoder is made of an encoder and a decoder. The principle of an autoencoder is to learn to reproduce a given input as precisely as possible in the learning phase. Thus, when training on normal data, the autoencoder learns the representation of normal events. In the prediction phase, it is therefore able to reconstruct as an output the inputs it has already seen. However, facing a new representation, it will not be able to reconstruct correctly the input vectors. The output vectors will be different from the input, and we can compute a reconstruction error. This reconstruction error is the sum of errors between input and output. If the reconstruction error is greater than a given result, we classify the edge as anomalous and we fit the corresponding event. The strength of the autoencoder is that it is self-supervised and does not need labeled data. Moreover, it allows us to see where the error was made, and thus an analyst can identify which attributes were wrongly reconstructed. You can see in this slide the autoencoder we use in our experiments. We will now present the details of our experimentations and the results obtained. We use a CICIDS 2017 dataset for our experimentation. This dataset contains 5 days of network capture from Monday to Friday. Monday contains only normal traffic, while the other days contain both normal traffic and heterogeneous attack. They are, for example, DOS, web attacks, botnets. These attacks are carried out on various systems, making this dataset representative of real traffic. From the capture file, we use IDS to generate the event log. For graph generation and storage, we use Gremlin and GenesGraph. Finally, the autoencoder has been implemented with the Keras library of Python. We are also conducting new experiments on the more recent and even more realistic dataset CICIDS 2018. The evaluation consisted of 3 steps. We first define an optimal threshold value for the reconstruction error value based solely on normal traffic. We then validated the value found with mixed traffic. And finally, we compare our results with the state-of-the-art approaches. We define the threshold value based on the false positive rate as a function of the reconstruction error. The objective is to find the optimal value. If it is too low on the left, we risk having too many false positives and thus overwhelming the security analyst. If it is too high, we risk having too many false negatives and thus missing attacks. Based on the traffic on Monday, which is solely normal traffic, we choose a value of 0.003. Indeed, above the threshold, the number of false positives remains fairly stable. We then look to see if this shows bias fair by considering 2 classic evaluation criteria in machine learning, namely recall and precision. The higher, the better. The recall evaluates if you are able to find all attacks related events, and the precision if the rate of false positive related to the true positive stayed manageable. We use the traffic containing attacks and evaluate possible results, the efficiency of our algorithm. A quasi-optimal recall can be obtained for a threshold value of 0.003. However, this value is rapidly decreasing for a higher threshold for the attacks RS bottleneck and infiltration. The precision is higher than 0.67, except for the heartbleed attack and the infiltration attack. However, we see in the previous slide that if we increase the threshold value, we will considerably decrease the recall value. The value of 0.003 seems to be optimal. The two cases of low precision, heartbleed and infiltration, can be explained differently. In the case of heartbleed, the low precision is explained by the silent nature of the attack. The low precision for infiltration can be explained by an abnormally large number of false positives. In the second case, the infiltration attack is completed by a post scan performed by the victim. This post scan massively impacts the neighborhood of the normal event linked to the scan, leading us to false positives. We compare our results with supervised baseline approaches according to five criteria, namely false positive rate, recall, precision, accuracy, and F1 score. The values in this table show that, while being an unsupervised approach, Sec2Graph achieves performance at worst slightly below the average of those obtained by the supervised one. The worst score is obtained for precision, even if we outperform 3 out of 7 techniques. Consequently, the false positive rate is also high from a security point of view. However, we think that our graph approach will allow analysts to eliminate false positives much faster than a standard approach. Indeed, we have found that false positives in this data set are interrelated, allowing for common analysis. And above all, we want to emphasize the recall score, which far surpasses that of all other approaches. To conclude, our contributions are the following. We propose a definition of a graph of security objects built from heterogeneous security events. We also proposed a way to efficiently encode a graph into vectors suited to machine learning algorithms. We then built an autoencoder able to detect anomalies on data structure as a graph. Finally, we proved the efficiency of the Sec2Graph approach by showing that Sec2Graph brings a significant improvement over a baseline of supervised algorithm. As FutureGraph, we consider 3 types of development. First, we wish to explore new ways of encode graphs with a wider neighborhood, for example. We also want to explore new types of autoencoder, like the LSTM autoencoder. Finally, we also want to improve the usability and the interpretability of the results for the analyst by proposing visualization.